Good morning, YouTube. The Mini needs some work today. So my wife sent me a text message earlier this week and showed me that the computer screen was saying that the brake pads are already shot. I think it's only got like 13,000 some odd miles. So we've already gone through a set of brake pads. And guaranteed that the front pads, not the rear. I bought some new front brake pads. We're gonna throw those on her John Cooper Works Mini today. Interesting quick story about that. They used to have a like full maintenance plan included with all Minis. Brakes, you know, oil changes and coolant and whatever. But they changed that, and when we bought this car, they didn't include brakes anymore. Now the fascinating thing is they said, oh, you know, for the first, I don't remember if it was 25,000 or 35,000 or whatever it was, if you want to include brakes in the service plan, it was like $950. And I said, no, I don't want that. And they're like, but it includes brakes. And I said, yeah, but I'm gonna do it myself. And they said, no, you can't do them yourself. And I said, well, yeah, I can. And they were adamant that no, you could not do them yourself. And they said, well, you're gonna lose money anyway because they're gonna cost more than that. In order for it to be true, the brakes would have to cost $950, or it would have to be half of that, and I'm gonna need two brakes, which is possible. So let's just go with that. Let's say that it's gonna go through two sets of brakes before 25,000 miles, which means that each set would have to cost like $475. I ordered these brakes online, the brake pads, with the sensor. This is the sensor. This is the thing that, you know, you have to replace, otherwise the computer keeps saying the brake pads are gone. $135 shipped. Yeah. So even if I do it twice, we're talking $270. Yeah, I'm gonna go with no, I made the right choice. Scare tactics kind of got me interested because it was like, when they said, no, you can't do it yourself, I was like, oh man, maybe there's some new computer thing, whatever. There isn't. So let's change some brake pads on this John Cooper Works Mini because I don't think it's gonna be a big deal. So here's what the brake pads look like. They do have a specific outer pad. See, outer, focus, outer pad and inner pad. So we gotta make sure we put those on the right spots. But other than that, brake pads, some brake pad stuff, and the sensor. All right, let's break these lugs loose before getting the car in the air. 17 millimeter. Got my new ultra low profile jack. Oh man, this thing's so much smoother than my old jack. This is nice. I'm gonna spray it with some brake cleaner just to kind of clean up stuff before we get in there. This is working on brakes, it's generally a good idea to wear some gloves because there's a lot of nasty chemicals and crap in there. That's some nasty crap. So these are actually Brembo brakes, and from screwing around the Ferrari, kind of learned that these Brembo brakes have this pin that holds the brake pads in place. Now someone actually commented on my videos that you can remove the pin and pull the pads out without actually taking the caliper off. So let's give that a shot. I'm not 100% confident that that's gonna work, but essentially what we're gonna do is use a punch to put in the pin hole, and we're gonna tap it with the hammer, and the pin should come out on this side and then this one right here. So that's the theory. We'll give it a try. I mean, I'm willing to experiment with this. So, all right. Pin's already kind of coming out. These go a little farther. About as far as we can go on that. I think we have to use some pliers or something on the other side. See if these work. Maybe he's got a little better grip. Seems to be making some progress. Uh-huh. Alright. Got the springs out. Yeah. Once the springs out, these things come out pretty easy. Ooh, those are gross. We're gonna have to hose those. We're gonna have to hose all these down with some more brake cleaner. Alright, so here's the big trick. Can this come out? It looks like it can. I think it has to be tapped out from the inside. I mean, so it's coming out, but it's in there pretty tight. Problem's gonna be, even if I get this sucker out, am I really gonna get another pad in there? I'm gonna have to compress the piston on this anyway, so let's just pull this off. So the bolts holding the caliper on are 18 millimeter, quite large. Oh, this stupid thing is right where I need to be. I'm gonna pop off the brake pad sensor just so I have more room there. This thing's out of the way. Ah, dang, the stupid plug for it is way up in here, so I'm gonna have to pop off this little clip and that bolt and get in there. Well, that's annoying. All right, so with the trim out of the way, you can see here is the brake pad sensor wire, so we can get it unclipped. Oh, there we go. Now we can disconnect it. There. Now I can get this thing totally out of the way. Now let's try and get this stupid bolt off holding the caliper to the car. I have to tap with the hammer since I have to pull our room. Jeez, oh Pete. That thing was down on 20 ugga-duggas. Oh crap. I think my only hope in this one is just to beat the bejesus out of it with the hammer. Alright, I finally, using my other breaker bar, got the damn bolt loose. What's crazy is, as soon as you get it just the slightest bit loose, this thing comes off like really easy. So it's got really good threads, it just, man, it was on there with a couple ugga-duggas. There. Come on. Jeez. There. Ha, that's funny. All right, there's the other one. Whew. Well, as you can see, it actually was worn. So these brake pads did not last very long. I should probably go check the miles while I'm here. Let's go do that real quick. So I checked it, it only has 12,529 miles. So 12,529 miles wore out from that to that. Yeah. Well, admittedly, these pads are not huge pads, so I have to tell my wife to stop being so hard on the brakes. All right, so now that we got the pads out, or the brake calipers out, the pads are off, we need to compress the brake pistons a little bit so that we can actually fit the new pads. So I've got my big ass C-clamp and we're gonna just smash these guys down. I'm gonna have to actually put a pad in there. Let's use one of the old pads because when you press one, it just pushes out the other. Just squish it in with the pad. Push the pad, in place, there. All right. All right, so we're gonna try and see if we can get these pads in there with the caliper on. So what I did is I just put it on and I only put the threads in a few so you can see it still moves around. That way I got plenty of play. And I think we need to clip this sensor in first. So lump faces in. Which means it goes like that. So get in there. There. All right. So you can see that's what it looks like with the sensor facing inwards towards the pad. It's nice and clipped in. Make sure it's on the inner pad. So this obviously goes on the inside. Get that in there. If it'll fit. Come on. We can go in. We're gonna be a bastard. totally fucked up. Here. Yeah, so I totally screwed up. So, turns out there's these little handy dandy glue pads that I need to put on. So basically this side goes into the little hole on the pistons, and then this side, this little white stuff comes off and it's got some sticky shit and it sticks to the actual brake pads. So I gotta take a damn thing apart again. The good news is I don't think I have to take off the wire for the sensor. I just need to take off the caliper again, put these back on. I hate when I screw up. All right. Undo the 20 ugga-duggas. So don't do what I did wrong. There. I think before I take this off all the way, I'm gonna punch out the pins. I don't want that pad to go bombing. All right. One of the pads still has the little thingies in there, so I need to pop those out actually. There, see? All right. So now, let's put on the new ones. All right, one's in. I think it's probably best to put it in, then take off the sticky. Yeah, see, this just clips right into the piston. I don't know if that's like to help the pads stay aligned or what, but. All right, that was not so bad. Of course now, there. It's funny how once you've done everything once, it's so much easier the second time. They get to do it three times, so I'll be an expert on this car. Given how small those brake pads are, I feel like I'm going to be changing these brake pads a lot. I guess I better get used to this. Admittedly, at least they're pretty easy. I mean, all things considered, other than the 20 ugga-duggas on the caliper bolts, everything else has been pretty easy so far. Get the wire in place so I don't mess that up. Get on the clippy. I said, get on the clip. There. Put down 20 ugga-duggas. Oh yeah. That's right. That's why I didn't do the clip. Have to get down to 20 ugga-duggas, then put on the wire clip. Gotta redo these pins. Just make sure the pins are aligned. Okay, good. All right. So, as long as I got it out, the spring goes in this way. See how it's got these bumps down? And basically, it means it flexes like that, right? And the pin goes through this little slot right here and here. So those two bend into place. So that's how you can tell if you got it aligned right. Oop. Like so. Tap, tap, tap-a-roo. Pins are in. Okay. Now we can put the wheel back on. These bad boys back on there. Now we torque them. Woo, done. Let's break the bolts loose first. Seem like to jump off. Get out of the way, wheel. Clean this thing up, this is pretty gross. Get the nasties off there. Now, if you'll notice, there is no brake sensor on this side. There's only one brake sensor, and it's on the driver's side. So that actually makes it a little bit easier. So we're gonna have to compress the pistons. I know I'm gonna have to get the caliper off, so I'm gonna try and take off these caliper bolts first. Save myself the headache of trying to do that once the brake pads are loose. Get this loose enough to get in there with this. All right, and let's check the bottom one. Oh, shit. There it goes. Let's tap the pins out. Just like last time, these pins are kind of tricky once they're in there. Got the caliper bolts. There. Oh. All right, so this time, making sure those little things are still on the pads. So to compress the piston, I'm gonna put back in the brake pad. All right, get it in the, come on, get in there. There, put that in there, and then we're gonna put the big old C-clamp on and just squish it. When I compress this side, it's basically just pushing out these pistons. So it's making it not exactly what I wanted to see. Every time I was compressing one side, it was basically just pushing the fluid to the other, and the pads were just going like this, moving back and forth. So what I did is I clamped this one in place, and now, because I'm such a he-man, I'm literally just squishing the piston back into place. So normally that won't work and you're gonna have to have two C-clamps. So I need to order a second C-clamp because that's not gonna work next time. As these pads get old, or as everything gets older and starts sticking more, yeah, there's no way. That was lucky as hell. And it's not actually saying I'm strong, because I'm not. So this time I'm not gonna screw up. I'm gonna put in my little holders in there first, so we just clip those in and then take off the sticker. Oops. See, there. We got the inner pad, outer pad. So inner pad, this side. Funny enough, it says BMW right on it. They don't even like try and hide that they're actually BMW parts. Pads are on. Let's get it clamped back on to place. Now we just gotta put the pins back in place. So make sure we got it oriented right. So you got, oh, there, got a pin in. And again, we gotta put this in the right direction. So get it right there. And there. There we go. The old tap, tap, taparoo. Whoa. Okay, just gotta get the wheel back on. Drop it down. All right. And we torqued them down. All the pads are back in place, so now we gotta get in the car, start it up, make sure we get the pads set, take it out, make sure they work, and then make sure the computer resets. Supposedly, I can't actually do this, but we'll find out. Also, we just recently had the tires changed, and I think the computer thinks that the TPMS system reset, so I gotta reset that. So let's do both of those and take it out for a quick spin. All right, we're in the Mini. Let's start her up. Whoa. Oh yeah.
You have to pump the brake a few times. There. Shut up, Blackview. Now the brake has some pressure. Alright, so let's turn around. Alright, yeah, it's a complaint about service. Brake system, drive moderately. Inflate tires. Alright, well. Alright, so. Let's reset the pressure monitoring system. Okay, so resetting the pressure. Alright, I was reading, so apparently you don't put your foot on the brake, you turn on the ignition. Alright, so hold on, I think it was on. Alright, so the ignition's on. Push and hold this button. Yeah. Push and hold. Push and hold. There it goes. Okay, that's reset possible. Okay, let's reset. Reset. Yeah, I want to reset. So push it again. Reset in progress. And... ta-da! Reset successful. No problem. So now I just need to get the TPMS working, so let's go drive it around. Alright. Apparently it needs to roll for that to get reset.
It's kind of funny. It tells you the percent complete on resetting the tire pressure. So hopefully once that resets, all my little catastrophic exclamation points will go away. So you got my... yeah, it's like, oh my god, you got stuff going wrong with the car. Oh man, it's at 15%, 16, 17, we're getting there, 30, 40, holy shit, 50, come on, 51, woohoo, it's reset, and everything seems happy, oh yay. So finally, everything seems like it's not complaining, and look, the little exclamation point is gone.
Alright, Minnie is back in business. Megan can social work the shit out of Austin. Brake pads are done, the wheel sensors are reset, no little exclamation points, no beeping sounds whenever you start the car now. All set, super easy, don't need to take it to Minnie, and certainly this is something you can do at home, and it cost me $135 for all the parts with shipping and taxes and everything. And it only took me less than 2 hours, and that was with screwing around with the camera and messing up on the pads, forgetting to put that little thingy in there. I bet you could do this in less than an hour, especially without farting around with the camera. $130, 1 hour of time versus $950 for the like maintenance package they want to offer. Yeah, fuck that. I made the right choice. Hopefully you enjoyed seeing stuff like that. Hopefully you enjoyed seeing me work on the Mini as well as the Ferrari. And pretty soon we'll obviously have to be working on the Corvette. So we got lots of cars to work on. I'm sure they're all gonna be needing all sorts of stuff. They're all gonna have problems as cars tend to do. Don't forget, we got the dash cam giveaway going on. So subscribe, share, send a screenshot to danplus15k@normalguysupercar.com. You'll be entered to win before I hit 15,000 subscribers. Once I hit 15,000, we'll be drawing. Two of you are gonna win dash cams. So stay tuned for that. We're gonna be doing lots of car stuff. It's gonna be sweet.